Hey. I am a little late at 7:03 Eastern Standard Time, and I am glad you're here. I am happy to be here, and we have a bunch of notes again from Heather. She has lit me up with a bunch of stuff, but we have good stuff tonight. We're going to talk about a vendor that struggled at an event. We're going to answer some questions. If you have questions, please fill them in below and in the comment section, and I'll be happy to get to them. Let's see here. I was supposed to wear today, as promised, a black shirt that said Boss Dogs. Boss Dogs sent me a kick butt shirt, and I wore it Sunday instead on the webinar. And seeing as how we don't do laundry every day around here, I would have been wearing a dirty shirt. Didn't want to do that. So that's just me. So let's get started. Let's get going here and see what's kicking. Okay. All right, here we go. Here's the vendor tip, okay? And this comes from a email from a vendor in Shelby, North Carolina. Hey, David, glad you're here. Thanks for joining us. It says, hey, Ben, hope all is doing well. Although I have only been vending for a little over a year, I thought I would share a lesson I just learned that may help other vendors. I only vend very, very part-time since I own two other businesses that have been around for 22 years and 9 years. Long time in business. I knew going in that I could not set up several days a week to build the following at the same location, so I work festivals and special events from March to November. Some I do for the ka-ching, the money. Ka-ching, I like that. And some I do just because they are downright fun. That's what's beautiful about this. If you can find what you love doing that is fun, you've found success. So it says that when the opportunity came up to work our county fair, which is our state's largest, I thought, cool, it is like working a festival except for 10 days straight. A lot of work, but the payout was going to be huge. Here's where it goes downhill from this. So grab your tissue, okay? I got my tissue. I hope you have your tissue. I was wrong. I set up and was ready to go during the preview night, which is the night before the fair officially opens, but the rides are running and people get in free of charge. Because I know the fair organizer and his team, I was assigned a prime spot and was on the main avenue of the fair. Long story short, the crowd was off, but still decent. I knew going in that I was new, but everyone loves my hot dogs, and my prices on my meal deal was the best deal out there. The price alone would ensure that I made thousands over the next 10 days. Long story short, serving from 4 p.m. to 10 p.m., I sold 6 hot dogs and 7 Frito pies. 6 hot dogs, exclamation mark. I was floored. How could this be? Same setup and same food that I kill with at festivals? 6 hot dogs? My head was swimming with questions of how this could be. Many sleepless hours later, I have the answer. To get that answer, I had to step back and think like a fairgoer and not a vendor. Here is what I came up with after speaking to many other fairgoers and vendors. A festival is an event. A fair is a tradition. By that I mean, in at least in my area, people may attend a festival this year. Hey, if you're just grabbing on, and I'm glad you're here. Heather's here. David's here. Howdy to all of y'all. I'm going to check and see if anybody else has commented. Nope, not yet. I know we have people on. We're going to be giving away a kick butt ebook tonight. Free, zero charge. Get it. By a street food pro in our group. You'll love him. Now, I remember going to the fair each year. Also, like Christmas, it has its own traditional foods. I remember going to the fair each year, and I would have a plan as to what I was going to eat. I'm going to start off with a turkey leg, then some roasted corn, then some vinegar fries, and finish up with a couple deep fried Twinkies. I would have this plan in place before the first carny pulled into town. A hot dog, sure, I love a hot dog, but I can get a good hot dog the other 364 days out of the year. There is a reason McDonald's don't sell that much on Thanksgiving Day. Talking to other fairgoers confirmed my hunch. They were there for the weird foods, and for them, the weird foods were as much as an attraction as the rides and games themselves. But surely, someone would want a good hot dog, right? Yeah, I'm sure. There are those that do, but they are not at the fair alone. Junior may want a hot dog while Dad wants a turkey leg and Mama wants a hamburger. The food stand right across the aisle from me offered all three along with about 25 other items that they could get in one spot. Me? Dogs, chips, drinks, and Frito pies. But what about my killer deal? Two dogs, chips, and a drink for $6 versus a turkey leg for $8. That's when I remembered. A friend of mine that works at a small loan place talking how people would come in and borrow $500 to go to the fair and spend all year paying it back just to do it again next year. I also remembered a friend who owns a convenience store saying he should close down the week of the fair because business is so slow. It hit me like Christmas. People are going to spend money on what they want, whether they can afford it or not. It is a once-a-year tradition, and they are going to eat the foods they want, play the games, and ride the rides if they are eating bologna the rest of the month. Luckily, I had not signed a contract or paid the nearly $1,000 space rental, and the fair manager let me pull out with no hard feelings at all. I did not pre-buy for the entire event, so I can use the stock on my next festival in 2 weeks. All in all, I lost about $200. Pretty cheap for a lesson learned. Sometimes there is more money to be made being the only vendor at the right event with only 500 people than being one of 100 vendors at an event with 50,000 people. Excellent advice. But, I gotta say this. I have done this. I have failed, okay? I have failed at events. I have failed at fairs. I know this. I teach this. He's right. He's 100% right. It's scary. The only thing different that I would have done, number one, I raised my prices at events. Everybody else does, and I'm paying a premium to be there myself. Number two, and I'm taking more risk being there. Number two, though, location is key even at an event. We had a vendor in Georgia, or South Carolina, one, who got put next to the porta potties. Bad lot, bad spot. You don't set up next to porta potties. Okay, you know what they smell like. They don't smell like crap, but they smell like chemical and crap, right? It's like a potpourri of crap. So here's my advice to this vendor. That gave this good advice. This is good advice. But I would change my menu. You're under event organizer umbrella at an event. A fair and festival has an event organizer. You're covered under their umbrella license, which means you can pretty much serve what you want. So could you have taken your same steam tables that's in every restaurant in America and put whatever you wanted in there? Shrimp fried rice, spaghetti, soup, barbecue, pulled pork, you name it, pasta. You could have done whatever you wanted. I would have stayed. Me, I would have stayed. I'm not bad-mouthing you. I'm not getting on to you or anything. Don't take this the wrong way. I'm saying I would have stayed. I would have figured out what they want to eat. And even though I couldn't provide the 25 menu item deal as the guy across the way, I would get my fair share because I would create something unique. I would have something awesome that I could scoop out of my steam table. A steam table is nothing more than any restaurant in America has. That's what they use. You can do anything in that. And a fair and festival is your opportunity. It's like the doors have opened up and said, angels are singing. Let's get this on. That's what I'd have done. But I'm with you. I'm with you. I'm not upset or anything. Here is a follow-up on previous question from Anna. Anna says, now I won't mention your name. If I don't have permission to mention your name, so you know this. Know this when you watch these. I won't mention somebody's name unless they have allowed us to. Okay? Not that I like send them an email. Please sign this and press hard 3 copies. I don't do that. What I'm saying is, if they post it in a public place, then I'm good to go. If you send me an email and I want to use it and I don't have time to ask your permission to, I'm just not going to use your name. I'm gonna just not use your name. So you can ask away and I'll protect your identity if you don't want to be known for asking a question. But I think you're awesome for asking questions and I'm proud of those people that freaking ask questions. Thank you for your support and having so many resources on hot dog vending. I do want to start the hot dog business, but I cannot decide whether to use a trailer or a cart. There is a used trailer parked in my backyard. My friend is selling it for $8,000, but I don't have that kind of money to begin with. I understand. At the moment, that's a lot of money to start. At the moment, I am following cottage laws, selling fruit pies, and the illegally selling fruit cups. I was planning to possibly include this if I buy the trailer. Do you recommend I buy the trailer or ask my friend if I could pay her in installments? Please let me know what you suggest. Here's my suggestion. Okay? Always start out as small as you can. Never, and listen, you won't hear much from me on this, but I will say this. I can't condone doing something off the books kind of thing. Okay? That'll look bad. But I'm proud of you. I'm proud of you, Anna, for taking control. But $8,000 is a lot of money. What are the odds that your friend isn't going to sell that anytime soon and would rather lease it to you, but you make a deal that any lease payments go towards the purchase price unless she sells it prior to you finishing paying for it? Then you're not under contract. You could write up a simple letter. I agree to lease this to Anna for $100 a day. Or $100 a week, or whatever it is, right? It's not being used anyway. It's free money to them. In exchange, I will credit Anna for every dollar she spends towards the purchase price of $8,000. At any point during the next 12 months, if I haven't sold this product, this concession trailer on my own, then Anna can buy it at any point she wants as soon as she comes up with a full $8,000, but she gets full credit for her payments. Why not? Why not, Anna? Come up with a deal that works for you and works for your friend. That works for everybody. I've done those deals. That's a great deal. Okay, great question, Anna. Thank you for posting it. Question from I Love Street Food Vending, message from Owen. Hi, Ben and Heather. Just got your instant vendor ebook and can't wait to read it. 2 questions though. I'm not seeing the link for the next Thursday's webinar. I have a link for you. If we're not able to make it, would it be available to watch later, EST, CST, PST, whatever times? Also, what do you think about using crock pots to boil the dog? Okay, first let me answer your first question. Go to learnhotdogs.com and Heather, if you're on here, could you post this up? learnhotdogs.com/start. Start, START. That's the link to the webinar Thursday I'm doing absolutely free. It's limited space, so get in there now. There's still space, though. I checked about 30, 40 minutes ago. And you can join. I pay for the space, and that's why I say there's limited space. So you can join live, ask questions. It's all about training. There's nothing to buy. We're just going to give you a bunch of information, help you make a decision so that you can do your due diligence and go. So that you have a head start, okay? You don't have to go plundering through the interwebs trying to figure it out. Next question. Oh, it's time-wise. We are trying to figure out a way to record it in a method that we could provide it after the webinar. So, Owen, I'm going to do my best to make sure that's possible. The second part of his email is, or message is, what do you think about using crock pots to boil the dogs for service? Do you think it would be a safe way to cook them and serve them until we're able to get a cart? If your state allows it, abso-freaking-lutely. A crock pot is nothing more than a circle steam table. It is nothing more. It's a heat source, ceramic typically, or a metal bowl lined, okay, a stainless steel bowl. Stainless steel is approved in all 50 states. And all you need to do is call your health inspector and go, listen, we want to serve hot dogs. Now, if you're going to be doing catering gigs and private events and setting up tables, use it anyway because it's legal. You're not violating anything there. But you can check all this out by talking to your health department inspector, whoever inspects the restaurants in your city or town or county. Depending on the size, there may be multiples of those, but you only need one. You just ask, get permission, get their name, go, thank you very much. We just want to use crock pots. We're going to need about 11 of them or whatever it is. I guess that was more than two. Let's see. Do you think it would be safe to cook? Yes, it's absolutely safe because all you do is heating up hot dogs. I guess that was more than two questions. Sorry, keep putting out the great knowledge bombs, and I can't wait for the next video. Thank you, Owen. Great information. And it probably helped more than just you. There's other people that capitalize off this information. It's why we do it. This one from I Love Street Food Vending right here. Okay? I Love Street Food Vending message from Zebulon. I love that name. Hi, Ben. Hope you're well today. I wanted to ask some questions concerning crowdfunding. What are your thoughts on funding the first few months of a lease versus an outright purchase? Do you lease carts out of state? Thank you for your time. Okay? This is kind of a multi-part question, I think. He says, first, what are your thoughts on funding the first few months of a lease versus an outright purchase? It's easy. Working it. You work the cart. What is a lease cost? Let's say we have a lease option on our site. We don't do it. We make not a penny off of it. It's just a third-party company who's been very good for us for about 2.5 years. We went through 7 or 8 companies to find that lease company. And it's not, when I say lease, understand me, it's not a lease. It's not like you lease it and then you turn it back in and it's over. No, you own it. At the end of the lease, you own it. So it's like a loan. They call it a lease. It's a loophole so that they don't have to have the credit criteria they would for a normal loan. So go lease. But let's say you went out, had never heard of me, never heard my video on leasing, and you didn't know any of the stuff, and you just jumped right in and you leased a freaking cart. And let's say they got you. Let's say they used car plaid pants got you. Too tight plaid pants got you. And you were paying $20 a month, a day. Okay? What's that? 620 times 30, $600 a month. And you go, oh my gosh, I'm paying $600 a month? Do you realize that one of my free courses is how to expand your business? And one of those is to buy other carts and lease those to vendors who can't afford them for $50 and $100 and $150 a day? Can you imagine? So $20 a day on a lease on something that you will definitely own is nothing. And that's worst case scenario nothing. I'm not selling anything here. I'm just telling you. If somebody told me in the beginning, I could have started a month earlier, for $20 a day, I could use their cart, and I could go out there and make $300-$400 a day. Oh my gosh, I'd have lost my noggin if I wouldn't have taken that. It cost me $20 to make $400. It's a duh. I'm not saying duh to this person asking the question. I'm just saying in general, that is one of those things that, you know, I'm giving a worst case scenario if it was $20 a day. Typically it's $5. You know, you might pay $150-$200 a month for a cart. There's people paying $500 a month for a freaking car that makes them no money and becomes worthless. Hot dog carts and food concessions increase in value. There's people selling my big dog cart that's 4 years old. Look it up on Craigslist if you don't believe me. Okay? That are selling my big dog carts for more than I sell them for new. They're selling 4 and 5 year old carts for more than I sell them for new. It's because they're there right now. You know, the person finds it and goes, oh, it's a Ben's Carts. It's a big dog. Oh, let me look up Ben's Carts. Looks it up, hotdogcartstore.com, goes on there and goes, oh my gosh, this cart's $3,000 here, but this guy's selling it for $4,200. There's a boy in Colorado that does this. He's selling it for $4,200. And he goes, yeah, but it's right here right now. You want it right now? Got it. $4,200. And he sells it. Crazy. It's amazing. Okay? So don't worry about that. Now, I want to talk about something. We're giving away that cool new steamer thing. I believe it is this Friday. Okay? So that's coming. I'm going through my messages. Make sure. Heather, if you have anything for me, if I've missed something, please post it up on the Skype-y thing. Because I can't see all the messages here on the Facebook thing. Let's see. I do want to thank our vendor, Boss Dogs, who sent me a shirt. I love it. I wore it Sunday on the long show. So 2 hours compared to this, the short show stuff. Thank you. I really appreciate you doing that. Let's see. And y'all can follow Boss Dogs. Okay, we have a new ebook, and this comes from, y'all know him, y'all know Michael Wood, Doug's Dogs, good is his slogan. There is no sense in you not getting this inspirational, helpful, motivational, heartwarming. It's like a Hallmark special, okay? That's Heather's words, Hallmark special. This is a good ebook, and it's free to you. Michael put it out so that vendors could feel the impact. And I hope you get this. I hope you take advantage of this. It'll be up for 24, 48 hours roughly. Grab it before it's gone. That's as long as it'll be. There's nothing to buy. You don't have to put in, you know, you don't have to send us kidney or anything. Vendor of the week this week is Marshall Dog. I don't know if you saw the picture. It's right there somewhere. Right, I think it's right here, maybe. Yeah, I think it's right there, if I'm correct. Picture. Two beautiful ladies standing in front of his trailer. Look at his site. Look at his site and look at the look at all the pictures they post and the stuff they do. They're awesome. Thank you for being our vendor of the week. You're awesome. So you want to learn about Michael Wood and his personal story, how he decided to start this business, and maybe to give you some encouragement. Maybe not to start. Maybe you already started. Maybe you need some encouragement, some words of encouragement. Check that out. Check that out. It's free. Okay. A couple other things, and then we'll go. Okay. Corey Lawrence just shared the link in the comments. Thank you, Corey. To the Boss Dogs Catering. Greg Crafton won the steamer, I think, last week. He just he used his new steamer tonight. Hopefully we'll have pictures of that up. He did send me pictures. I sent them over to Heather, so we should have those on the somewhere sometime. Let's see. You can tell I'm getting old. It's hard for me to see my computer screen. Live training. Can you imagine this? Imagine this. Imagine going to somebody like Michael Wood. Somebody, heck, not like Michael Wood. Imagine going and spending a day with Michael Wood. Or imagine spending a day with Jason Brown, Corey Lawrence, Matt Gladfelder. Can you imagine spending the day with somebody like this, a pro vendor, what you would pick up? Would it double your income when you came back with the tips and stuff you learned? Would it just inspire you, put you on cloud nine? Well, you can now. We've been asked to do this forever. And I'm excited to tell you we have it, okay? I don't remember the link. I have a short link for it. Oh, I know the short link. LearnHotDogs.com/GoPro. GoPro. LearnHotDogs.com/GoPro. You can work hands-on with a freaking awesome vendor. How does it get... Makes me happy. Okay. Now, we have a webinar this Thursday. I know that there are you who have friends or family or know people, acquaintances, whatever, who could use some encouragement. There is nothing for sale. I'm not pawning off a course. I'm teaching straight from the heart Thursday. I'm going to give as much information as I can, answer as many questions as I can about getting started. I'm going to help people figure out if this is the right thing for them. It's free. All you got to do is sign up. Okay? There's limited space. But if you have a friend, a family member, or anybody that you want to share that with, I'd appreciate it. Share it with them. Make the world a better place kind of thing. If you've been venting a while, you know how that feels. If y'all didn't see the video I posted today of Matt talking about the impact, that was just an excerpt from Sunday night's live show. And that was just an excerpt. And I posted that up today somewhere on the page of Matt talking about the impact this has had in 1 year. That he was there when his child walked for the first time. That he hasn't missed anything with his family for a year now because he's been vending. That nobody, he doesn't have to check in with nobody. I think the correct pronunciation or grammar is no one, but for me, I said nobody. Y'all get me? So that's what he's done. I hope you watch that video. You want to be inspired? Get Michael's book that we're giving away right now. Get the little, it's a short ebook, okay? And then watch that video. Watch that video tonight. Feel better. Feel better. Even if you've been vending for 25 years, it doesn't matter. We all need an uplift. We need to remember how good we have it. How good it is. Matt touched that perfectly Sunday night. And that's Bow Ties and Hot Dogs, if you don't know who that is. You can look him up on Facebook. But do that. We're doing this thing Thursday. I hope you'll share it. I hope you'll come if you need to come. If you need some words of encouragement and you want to learn the basics of the business, you want to learn how to get started, pros and cons. I'm going to be the negative one too. Negative Nelly. I'm not just going to tell you how good everything is. I'm going to give you the negative too. I'm going to tell you, okay, but here's the facts. Okay? You do this. There's pan cleaning and stuff. There's crap. I love y'all. I know you'll do great, okay? Come to this thing Thursday. Grab the free stuff today. Check it out. And be encouraged. Be inspired. And if you aren't, it isn't right for you, share it with somebody that it might be. Share it. It changed my life. Hot dogs saved my life. Anyway, you'll hear that story Thursday. And I'll do it briefly. I'm not going to talk for hours and hours. Anyway, we've done a lot of stuff tonight. Thank y'all for the questions. Thank you, thank you, thank you. There's a question area where you can already pre-post them up for the webinar Thursday. You can do it right now. You can go in there and post your question, and I'm going to answer them. So, y'all have a freaking fantastic evening. I know this ran long, but I enjoyed it. I enjoyed every second of it. See you later.